Good morning, student. Today we will discuss about aggression. Aggression, it is a range of behaviors that result in both physical and psychological harm to oneself, others, or objects in the environment. Or we can say, aggression, it is a form of behaviors directed towards the goal of harming or injuring another's living being. Okay, aggression, it is a form of behaviors directed towards the goals of harming or injuring another's living things. Aggression, it is a behaviors, it is a form of behaviors directed towards the goal of harming or injuring another's living beings. Or we can say, aggression, it is a range of behaviors that result in both physical and psychological harm to oneself, others, or object in the environment. What are the causes? Usually, in child, the cause of aggressions may be due to poor relationship, poor with friends, family. Due to health conditions, stress, tension, etc. These are the cause of aggressions in child. Stress, fighting, relationship, poor during argument, stress, fighting, poor relationship due to high pressures, etc. And in adults, the cause of aggressions may be due to poor relationship. Poor relationship with family members, friends, job stress. Okay, due to job stress, tension, ego, health, unhealthy health. health condition, health conditions, etc. Mentality, etc. These are the cause of admission. In admission, the cause are poor relationship with family members, friends, health conditions. If the child is not, if the health condition of the child is not good, then he may be aggressive, stress, tension, etc. In teenagers, the cause of aggressions may be due to poor relationship, fighting, shouting during arguments, stress, high pressures, etc. And in adults, the aggressions may be due to poor relationship with family members, friends, stress of job, argument, tension, pressure, injury, disease, weakness, etc. Next is form of aggression. Forms of aggressions. Aggression may be physical, mental. Okay? Aggression may be physical, mental, verbal or emotion. This is about the form of aggressions. Okay, aggressions, it may be in the form of physical, mental, emotional and verbal. Purpose of aggression. What are the purpose of aggression? The purpose of aggression is to dominate. To dominate others, to sow pain, anger, hate. Okay, to sow anger, hate, pain, to achieve goal. That may be physical and psychological harm to oneself, others or object in the environment. Aggressions, it may be in the form of physical, mental, verbal or emotional. And the purpose of aggression is to dominate others, to achieve the goal, to sow the pain, hate, treating or intimidate, to respond fear, failures, etc. Next is type of aggressions. Aggression, it is of three types. Impulsive, or we can say hostile aggressions, instrumental aggressions and assertive behavior aggression. Types of aggression. Aggression, it is of three types: impulsive, or we can say hostile aggression, impulsive or hostile aggressions, instrumental. These are the three types of aggression. Impulsive is also known as affective aggressions. In these aggressions, hostile aggressions, it is often an instant. It is caused due to a strong emotion of anger. It is not pre-planned. Okay, hostile aggressions, impulsive aggressions. Impulsive aggression, it is instant, it is not planned, it comes due to strong emotion of anger. The aim of impulsive aggression is to achieve the goal. Okay, the aim of impulsive aggression is to injure others. For example, something when someone come in front of you while driving, etc. And instrumental aggression, it is well organized and planned. The aim of instrumental aggression is to achieve the goal by using aggression. In instrumental aggression, it is well planned, and the aim is not to injure, but the aim is to achieve the goal by using the aggression. For example, football players using aggressions to tackle their opponent to gain the goal. Okay, his intention is not to injure, but his goal is his aim is to achieve the goal. For example, if he is playing football, then he show his aggression to gain the football, etc. And last is assertive behavior aggression. In assertive behavior aggressions, asserting the person use legal, physical or verbal force to dominate the verbal force to achieve one purpose. Okay, in assertive behavior aggressions, the person use legal, physical or verbal force to achieve one purpose. For example, shouting during game to dominate the players, to psychologically dominate the player. Okay, for example, in cricket, if a player take the wicket, then he will shout to make his opponent psychologically disturbed. So this is about the these are the type of aggression. Impulsive aggression, it is not planned. Okay, it is not planned. It comes by a strong feeling of anger, strong emotion of anger. The aim is to injure others. Okay, the aim is to injure others. For example, shouting when someone comes in front of you. Instrumental aggression, it is planned, it is well planned. And the aim is to achieve the goal by using aggression. And last, assertive behavior aggression, the person uses legal, physical or verbal force to achieve one purpose. For example, shouting to make their opponent psychologically discomfort, etc. Okay, these are the type. Now, aggression in sports. What are aggression in sports?
For example, in shooting, archery, etc.
And if we use aggression in this type of game, then our performance will decline, reduce. So aggression has positive as well as negative effect in our performance. Next is, what are the factors influencing aggression? The first is temperature. Usually, if the temperature is high, then the person will become aggressive more fast. Okay, high temperatures leads to high aggressions of an individuals. Next is perception of the victim. If a person knows the perception of the victim, then his aggression will be more. Okay, if an athlete perceives their opponent. Perceive the opponent intentions. Then, if the athletes know the intentions of their opponent, if the intention of his opponent is to injure, if he know, then he will play aggressively. Next is fear of. Fear of retaliation means it can be inherited towards the opponent of both fears and respect. Unsportsmanship. They will play with unsportsmanship spirit. Okay, fear of retaliation means the players often use less lightly to allow the unsportsmanship play if they are likely to exactly the same impact. If they get same impact, then they will play with retaliation means revenge. If a players play for the revenge, then the aggression will be more. Okay, if the players play for revenge, if the aim of the athletes is to take the revenge, then they will play with more aggressively. Game structure. If a person knows the structures of the game, okay, for example, the structure of game. For example, there is a big difference in the point. Then the player who has less point, he will have more aggressive. Okay, if the difference in point is more, then there will be more aggression in the game. For example, if the difference in point is one team point is 10 and other team point is 20, then the 10 players. The players whose point is 10, he will play with more aggressively. Traditional. If a players compete for the same thing, okay, if they compete for the same things, then there will be the more aggressiveness in the game. home ground, home, home ground. Usually the players who come from outside, they have a lot of pressures, okay, because the home ground players, they will have less aggressiveness, the audience will support them, and the players who come from outside, they have high pressures, therefore the aggression will be more. Okay, players playing on home ground, the players playing on home ground, they have less aggressiveness because the audience will support them, and the players who come from out of station, they will have more aggressiveness due to pressures, due to spectators pressure. Skill, if the ability of the skill is good, then we will have less aggressiveness, and if the skill of the player is not good, if he has less skill, then his aggression will be more. So these are the factors that influence aggression. Okay, temperatures, if the temperature is high, then there will be the more aggressions. Perception of the victim, if the athletes know the intention of the victim, then they will play with more aggressively. Fear of retaliations, if the person wants to take their revenge, then there will be the more aggressiveness. Game structures, if the structure of the game, if the difference in point is more, then there will be the more aggressiveness. Traditional rivalry, if the player compete for the same things, then there will be the more aggression. Home ground, the player who play in home ground, they will have less aggressions because the audience, spectators will support him. Skill ability, if the person has good skill, he will have less aggression, and the person who do not have skill, whose skill is less, we will have more aggression. Next is aggression. Aggression. Aggression management. Aggression management technique. First is deep breathing. Whenever you feel aggressiveness, take a long deep breath. You can also do pranayama, like anulom vilom, etc. Okay, it has to reduce your aggression. So whenever you become aggressive, take a long breath. Drink water. Drink. To reduce your aggressions, drink water. But do not drink over. Okay? Avoid over drinking of water. Drink water whenever the symptoms of aggression is formed. But do not drink over drinking. Okay? Avoid over drinking. Follow the advice. Always follow the advice of the teachers, coach, means senior. Follow the advice of the seniors. Psychological balance. Stress, tensions, etc. Psychologically ready. Okay, this had to reduce the aggressions. Do not take any stress, tensions. Prepare yourself psychologically for the activity. Next is focus on your target. Focus on your only focus on your target. Do not think useless things. Okay, take on full focus on your target and sufficient practice. Do a sufficient practice. Encouragement, have a confidence. Participate physical activities. Stay cool. Always stay cool and confidence. Avoid the company of stressed persons, etc. Okay, whenever you feel aggressiveness, drink a sufficient water, take a long break, follow the advice of the teachers. Psychologically ready for the activities. Have a confidence. Do a sufficient practice. Encouragement. Preparation in physical activity. Participate in physical activity. Stay cool and comfortable.